Now, continuing, we also see that the gospel involves the revealing of Jesus personally to us. Verse 15. But when it pleased God, who separated me from my mother's womb and called me through his grace to reveal his Son in me, that I might preach him among the Gentiles, I did not immediately confer with flesh and blood. You see, when we talk about justification by faith, faith is not just some mental agreement to this ideology. Oh yeah, Jesus died for my sins. Rose from the dead. Okay, he's God. All right, fine. It's entering in by faith into the life of the risen Jesus, putting ourselves in his hands, just trusting him and him alone as our Savior. It's something supernatural that takes place. And the Bible tells us that those of us who are believers were chosen in Christ before the foundation of the world. Elsewhere we read that all of us who have been justified were previously foreknown by God. And Paul acknowledges that here, doesn't he? Yeah, there was a time when the Son was revealed in me, but I was separated from God from my mother's womb. Put it another way, God is not sitting on the edge of his seat when someone is sharing the gospel, and they're saying to the angels, do you think he's going to believe today? What do you think? You think he's going to receive? God knows. God knows who are going to believe and who is not. But that does not limit our responsibility in any way to respond. Yes, God knew the day when I was 25 years old that I would become born again. He knew that day. But I could have been born again far earlier than that. I remember when I was fairly young. I don't remember how old, but I was probably fifth or sixth grade. And I just had this desire to read the Bible and to learn about Jesus. I used to like to read a lot. Keep in mind, this was before the internet, before the home computer at all. And TV only had 7 channels. We did have video games, but you can only play Pong for so many hours. And I got my Bible, and I opened it, and I started to read, and I think I lasted a day. I don't know what happened. I don't know if I got discouraged. I don't know if I got confused. I don't know if I got bored, but I know I stopped. And I know I didn't really have anyone praying for me or encouraging me in the faith. It was just something that just was prompted in my heart and pretty quickly went away. Because it's a spiritual warfare out there. And the last thing the devil wants is some 12-year-old kid reading the Bible, searching for God. And since I am only just a 12-year-old kid and I didn't have anyone upholding me, I'm sure it was pretty easy for him to get me distracted on the things of the world rather quickly. The good news is that even though all those years, on the one hand, were wasted years, I wish I had been a Christian, I also know that God uses the past for his purposes and for his glory now in the present. I know that there's opportunities of ministry available to me because of my experiences out in the world, living after the flesh, living for sin, that would not be the same opportunities had I been walking with the Lord ever since I was in fifth grade. So I praise God for that. But at the same time, if any of you are thinking, you know what, I think I'll just get a little more life experience for that day someday. I'll just live out in the world a little bit. I like what you just said there, Steve. No. Don't be deceived. The Bible's very clear. Now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation. If you have not put your faith in Jesus Christ, and again, not some head knowledge extent. Yeah, I agree with all that stuff. But joining in living union with the risen Christ by faith, by trust, by belief, then you need to do so today. You need to be born again. And when you are born again, we see that the gospel insists on the reexamination of all our beliefs. Look at verse 17. He has just said that once I got saved, once Jesus was revealed to me, I did not immediately confer with flesh and blood. I didn't talk to anybody. Verse 17, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to those who were apostles before me, before him in time, not prominence or status. I went to Arabia and returned again to Damascus. And then after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to see Peter, remain with him 15 days, but I saw none of the other apostles except James, the Lord's brother. Now concerning the things which I write to you, indeed, before God, I do not lie. Paul was a Pharisee. He thought that his righteousness, his justification, was by faithfully, meticulously keeping every little detail of the law of Moses and all the traditions around the law of Moses as well. And so he had a radical paradigm shift, didn't he? And what he's saying here is, when I got saved, I didn't run to the apostles in Jerusalem and say, okay, guys, tell me what I should believe now. He says, I got alone with my Bible and with the Lord for the first time, with the Holy Spirit indwelling me. And I looked at those scriptures that I knew so well as a Pharisee in a whole new light. And I love it because I do not fear one bit what anyone will come to believe simply if they read their Bible with a seeking heart as a believer in Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit indwelling them. I don't have the slightest fear. You see, we don't want to take this too far. And as some people I have heard say, see, we don't need any teachers. We all just have the Bible. We have the Holy Spirit. We can all just do it on our own. Now, I encourage all of you to read the Bible, but the Bible is very clear also that God has placed in the body of Christ teachers to edify us in our walk. Remember something about Paul in the context here. First of all, Paul certainly knew all the Hebrew and Greek. Do we? Because that's what the Bible was written in originally. Paul was living in the history, living in the culture. Do we know all about first century history and first century culture and the Jewish traditions and the Greek culture and the Roman government and all that? Because a lot of that bears on our understanding of the Bible. Paul knew all that. And of course, Paul knew the scriptures from cover to cover. A lot of times people have a mistake as to what a Bible verse might teach because they don't understand the whole counsel of God. We do need to interpret scripture with scripture. So God has placed in the body of Christ teachers, and those teachers should be studying those sorts of things to be able to share the word of God with the body of Christ. It's not just a teacher get up, well, here's what I think I see in here. No, it's a call to preach is a call to study, it has been said. And so, by God's grace, I put in the hours of study to help you in understanding the scripture. But basically, wherever I'm at, you could get to the exact same place. You could get to the exact same place. You put in the time, you put in the study. I'm not asking you to believe anything I say just because I've said it. And that's what Paul's getting at here. Look, I'm not going to the apostles there in Jerusalem and saying, guys, tell me what I should believe, and I'll believe it now. A lot of people do that. God will instruct us through his word. If you're a child of his, you have the Holy Spirit indwelling you, but we need to re-examine all of our beliefs in light of the authority of God's word. We mentioned evolution earlier. Any Bible-believing Christians who still are completely devoted to Darwinian evolution? Why? Tell me where you see that in this book. Well, Pastor, I was listening to this guy. Well, there's your mistake right there. You were listening to some guy. What did that guy tell you? Well, he told me that sometimes those days in the Bible can be long eras of time, you know, millions of years. You're not going to get that from the Bible. Yeah, it's true that the word day can sometimes mean an era, but you're not going to get the idea of the creation week with long eras. When it's so clear, as God is establishing the Sabbath, for example, he says in 6 days he created everything, the seventh day he rested. By the way, that word day, when it's accompanied with a number, the first day, the second day, the third day, always speaks to a 24-hour period. Did that guy tell you that in his message? No, he didn't mention that. See, I have no fear what you're going to come to believe if you just read the Bible.